Hello everyone, welcome to Learn Languages with Shadil Khan, your fastest and easiest way towards fluency.
Hello everyone, this is Shadil Khan and today we are going to start with the lesson, the expression. Today we are going to learn an expression, I have, that is tengo que, like when we say with a stress form that I have to do this, tengo que hacer, hacer. Like this way, we are going to look at the more conjugation. So we know that the verb for tener, the conjugation is tieno, tienes, tienes, tengo, tengo for I form, for you form, and he or she form, it will be tiene, T-I-E-N-E, tiene. So the ending is O, E-S, and here we have ending E because it's an ER verb. So we are going to remove that and tenemos. T-E-N-E, tenemos, tenemos, and tienen, T-I-E-N-E-N, tienen. So you have to keep in mind one thing, that when we are making this, when we are translating this, so here we have the stem changing, that means E changes into I-E. So we are going to study more about this, the stem changes, stem changing verbs. So in our later slides or in my future lessons, I will teach you this. But the thing is that for now you have to remember this because we are going to use this form of tener in our translation. So she has to accept and she has to marry, like this boy, he loves a lot to this girl. So he's saying that she has to accept, like he's saying to his friend and all that, no matter whatever the situation is, she has to accept. So for she, we are going to, the word for accept is aceptar, aceptar, it's an AR form of verb. And for marry, it's casar, C-A-S-A-R, casar. So again, it's an AR form of verb. So it has been derived from the word casa, which means house. So you might have heard the word La Casa de Papel. There is a famous series going on. So La Casa de Papel. So from there, we can remember that someone who is marrying and they are living in a house. So they are making a house. They are making a house altogether. We can say they are making a family. From this trick, you can remember this word. So now let's look at the translation. For she, we are going to write ella. Ella has, it is going to be the conjugation. She has, tiene, ella. T-I-E-N-E, tiene, tiene, que, so that is for the stress, tiene que, tengo que, like we are putting a stress, like she has to marry, so that is why this is the K we add for stress, and for accept, we are going to write aceptar, A-C-C-E-P-T-A-R, aceptar, ella tiene que aceptar, and she has to marry, and for and, we are going to write E, ella, for she, we will write ella, tiene, tiene que casar, and she has to marry, like this way you can say. And now, he has to propose that girl. So here is a famous scene from a movie, Main Hoon Na, where Shah Rukh Khan is proposing to Sushmita Sen. So when he saw her for the first time, he started singing a song for her. So now let's look at the translation of this. He has, again we have the third person conjugation here. So él tiene que, so again he has to, we are giving stress over there. To propose is proponer, proponer, proponer. For that we are going to write esa. For girl, we are going to write chica, chica. So when we write that he has to propose that girl, so tiene que proponer esa chica. So proponer, this is a word. Now we have another word like suppose, suppose. So again, there is a pose at the ending. So for suppose, we are going to write suponer, P-O-N-E-R. For oppose, like there are word like oppose. So we are going to write oponer. Oponer. So all the pose word we can remember by this example. So now here I have to go to the cinema with my girlfriend. So again I have to go. So for I have we are going to write tengo. Tengo que. I have to. Tengo que ir. For to go we are going to write ir. For to the cinema or to the cinema we should say like this, to the cinema. A, for two we are going to write a, for the cinema is El Cinema. Cine, C-I-N-E. El Cine. So now here we have to look that A and L. So we have two vowels over here. So I told you in my previous slides that if we have two vowels like this, we are going to combine them and make them one. So it will be Al Cine. For with, we are going to write con. For my, we will write me. For girlfriend, the word is Novia. N-O-V-I-A. Tengo que ir. Like I have to go is tengo que ir. Ir is the word to go. That is an irregular verb. I am hungry. So it is again from my T5 lesson. So when you have to say I am hungry, so you say that I have hunger. Tengo. T-E-N-G-O. Tengo. For hunger, we are going to use hambre. H-A-M-B-R-E. Hambre. I have to eat. So the word for to eat is comer. C-O-M-E-R, comer. It's an E-R form of verb. So for I have, you have to write tengo que. So here, you are not putting a stress. Tengo hambre. You are just saying that I have hunger. But when you say tengo que comer, like you are stating, you are giving stress onto that you have to eat something. Or otherwise, you are going to write tengo muriendo de hambre. I am dying out of hunger. Ronaldo has to score a goal in order to win. So, for the time being, let's keep this as it is because it is going to be a hectic for you. So, to win, the word is ganar, G-A-N-A-R, ganar. So, it's an AR form, like to gain something out of someone. So, you are winning the situation. So, in this way, you can remember this. In order to is para. So, Ronaldo has to. So, Ronaldo tiene que, T-I-N-E, tiene que, Ronaldo has to score a goal in order to win, para ganar. So, I'm going to tell you the translation of this in later slides because I'm going to use my another character, Messi also. So, I think that this is the last slide. So, I am feeling sleepy. So, again, that I am feeling sleepy. So, I have sleep. You generally say in Spanish that I have sleep. So, tengo. T-E-N-G-O, tengo sueño, S-U-E-N-U, sueño. So this is the word for if you are feeling sleepy, and this is also a word for dream, D-R-E-A-M, dream. I have to sleep. So the word for to sleep, we are going to write dormir, D-O-R-M-I-R, dormir. It's an I-R form of verb, A-R-E-R and I-R, dormir. So for I have, we are going to write tengo que, T-E-N-G-O. Tengo que. So you can remember this word sleep as dormir, like dormitory. What you do in dormitory, you generally sleep, and we say that it's a dormant volcano. That means it's a sleeping volcano. So if you are going to look at the root of this, the Latin root exactly, you can get to this word and you can remember this easily. So that's all for today. So if you have not subscribed and liked my channel, so please subscribe and like this video and share it as much as possible, because I already told you that it takes a lot of effort to make a single video. So it's my request that if you are going to share this, so it will be good for me. And also if you are benefited, then please subscribe. Thank you everyone. See you in the next class.